What's up, YouTube? I want to start off by saying thank you to all the new subscribers, and I really appreciate you guys subscribing to the channel. And I'd like to let you know I have a vision for this channel, a vision of doing big giveaways and helping people and doing something that's never been done before with this trucking industry, with this trucking game, and helping you guys to get to another level. So I say thank you to all the new subscribers and all the subscribers that were here from the get-go. I just wanted to do a video on the couple of the common mistakes that I know that when I take people to the DMV to test, they usually mess up on the air brake test. So I just wanted to do a couple of tips on your air brake test. So hopefully you won't forget and you'll pass the first time. So one of the common mistakes, see, they do the tug test. They do the tug for the truck. They do the tug for their trailer, or tug for your trailer, tug for your truck. And then they do their service brake test. When they roll up and do their service brake test, the biggest thing I see that people forget to do is when you roll up and do your service brake test, you make sure you're in first gear, you cut the truck off. And when you cut the truck off, the biggest thing I see that people do is they forget to turn the truck back on. You have to have the truck back on so that you can get your warning buzzer. So I see a lot of people, they roll up, they do their service brake test, they cut the truck off, and they never turn the truck back on so they can, you gotta have your auxiliary power. You don't wanna turn the truck all the way back on. You just wanna get auxiliary power going so that you can get your warning alarm. So that's one big thing that I see. So don't forget to turn the key back on, okay? After your service brake test, when you roll up and you're checking to see if it's pulling from left to right, because you might have a brake out of adjustment, you wanna cut the truck off, make sure you're in first gear, cut the truck off, let the clutch out. You wanna, when you cut it off, my tip is to leave your hand on the key so that you won't forget to turn the key back on. Leave that hand on the key. That'll jog your memory. Okay, I need to turn my key just back on to auxiliary power. And another common thing I see is people, when they roll up to do their service brake test, they stop and they pull their brakes out. And they set the brakes and they forget to push the brakes back in. So your brakes have to be in so that your brakes can pop out when you're doing your air pressure loss alarm. So I see a lot of people, they roll up, they do their service brake test, they pull both buttons out, and when they set their brakes, they never push the brakes back in. Don't even set the brakes so you don't have that problem. If you set the brakes, you might forget to push them back in. When you roll up and do your service brake test, all you want to do is make sure you're in first gear, cut the truck off, the transmission will hold you in first gear so you don't need the brakes. Then you make sure you turn that key all the way back to auxiliary power so you can get your alarm. And another thing I see that people do is when they do their tug test and then they do the service brake test, they skip doing the applied pressure test altogether and they go straight to the low pressure loss alarm test. Don't forget to do that your applied pressure test where you put your foot on the brake. And you will not lose no more than 4 PSI in 1 minute. Don't skip that part and go straight to pumping the brakes. I see a lot of people skip that. They go straight to pumping the brakes. Just a couple of tips that I hope will help some people pass their tests. And if you have any questions or comments or you want to ask anything, please leave a comment. And please like and subscribe to the video and this channel. It'll help us grow. And we're helping us grow. Sooner or later, we're gonna be able to help some of the subscribers grow. Also, one other tip is, when you're doing your leak down loss alarm test, you wanna make sure both of your buttons pop out, the yellow and the red. Make sure they both pop out. One other quick tip is, when you're doing your service brake test, after you do your tug test and then you do your other tug test, when you get ready to do your service brake test, make sure both are, your yellow and your red are both pushed in so that your truck doesn't stall out when you get ready to do your service brake. You got to have your brakes off so the truck will move.